Before we start explaining the boot stages, we need to first know what happens exactly when you press the power button of the machine. So the first instruction executed by processor when it comes out of reset is reset vector. It is like a beginning of the world, universe and everything, but on the silicon level. Typically, it is located at a fixed memory address, dependent on the architecture. For example, on ARM, it is a zero address. The primary core loads the program counter and starts executing from address pointed by core stack, primary core stack pointer, which instructs the core to load its reset handler along with stack pointer vector table and read the processor's start address to get the application boot address and jump to that location. On the other hand, on x86, the reset vector is located at 16 bytes below 4 gigabytes. But this is what it looked like for most of the lifetime of x86 architecture. Nowadays, the silicon vendors tend to break this architectural rule by changing the reset vector address or execute the code before the CPUs are released from the result. Few examples of such behavior are, for example, Intel authenticated code modules, microcode updates, management engine bring up, custom reset vector in bootguard. On the other hand, AMD also have similar mechanism like the PSP bring up and memory training. PSP also copies the firmware to run to DRAM before the CPUs are released from reset, or can also have some custom entry point for the first instructions.